Hi guys, and welcome to another video from Wildlife Impulse. In today's video, let's talk wolves. I'm gonna break down the characteristics of a wolf track. As wolves are making their comeback in Europe, I wanna give you some insights on how to recognize a wolf track. As it's not always easy, as they look quite similar to dogs. First of all, I want to point out that wolves are avoiding humans at all costs, and wolf attacks in Europe are very scarce nowadays. Before we're gonna look into the wolf tracks, we first need to have a basic idea about the size and the characteristics of the species. So wolves are actually a very large dog, which have like a head to body length of about 1 meter. So that's about this size. So it's quite big, and they weigh up to 40 kilograms. I'll create a video on how to identify a wolf with all the characteristics and stuff in the future. So if that's something that you're into, consider subscribing and make sure you get notified for new videos. Alright, let's get into the wolf tracks. Tracks of wolves are very similar to dogs, as they're kind of in the same family. But wolf tracks are in generally larger than the dog tracks. They're roughly like 8 to 12 centimeters. There are a couple of other characteristics to distinguish between those two. First of all, they both have 4 toes and a heel pad. Whereas cats have retractable claws, members of the canid family or dog family have claws which are almost always visible in the tracks. Most of the pictures that I will show you are coming from snow tracking in Slovakia, but I include some tracks of wolves in the mud and sand as well. Alright, let's first compare the wolf and the lynx in this picture, and you can see that the wolf track is more symmetric than the lynx track. And the track of the wolf actually looks a bit like a droplet. The two front toes are more in the front of the track, which is actually kind of an indication it's a wolf. The other two toes are more triangular shape. In wolves, those two front toes will mostly also push deeper into the substrate, whereas they leave a deeper print, as wolves are more running on their toes than dogs do. And obviously this is more prominent in like soft soil than in the hard soil. In general, in wolves there is a bit more of negative space, so space in between the toes, than compared to dogs, which actually means that the two front toes are more to the front and there's less overlap between the two front toes and the two side toes. It's mostly described as with wolves you can make like an X shape in between the toes, whereas in the dog they usually say it's more like the shape of an H. Then if you look at the heel pad, it's more triangular. It's actually similar to all the other carnivore species. The front track is bigger than the hind track, and this is because the front track actually, or the front feet, needs to hold much more weight and are more for stability, as they need to carry all the weight of the head and the shoulders and stuff, whereas the hind legs are more narrow and they're more for like the creating speed and power. They need to like run or make to get somewhere fast. Usually if you look at tracks, it's always worth to look at the bigger picture, so look at the other tracks. And actually that's one of the biggest characteristics to identify wolves and dogs, as wolves are tend to walk in a straight line. They don't like to spend unnecessary energy, so they're very careful with their energy consumption. So they usually, it looks like if you look at all the tracks, they seem to have like a goal in mind, whereas dogs, you've probably seen walking a dog around as well, they're just like running around everywhere. Looks like they just have, they don't have a purpose of their walking in mind. So they're actually just like more wandering around. And definitely like you'll see here in deep snow, often wolves, they will follow in each other's footsteps. So that's again energy saving measurements. And so quite often you find one track, and then suddenly that one track splits into a couple of tracks and then comes back to each other kind of in a straight line. And all right and did you know wolves actually have very powerful jaws, and they're able to crush bones? That's another characteristic if you're looking more into figuring out what wolves have been eaten, but that will be a bit far for this video. As I said, dogs are coming in different sizes, breeds and stuff. So it's not always easy to distinguish between the two. But I hope in this video you get a bit of an insight. And to summarize, I'll have a quick overview, tell you about the main characteristics of a wolf track, is that they're mostly larger than dog tracks. They have four toes. Claws are mostly visible. They have a droplet kind of shape. Usually you can see this X pattern in the negative space very well. And if you happen to find more than one track, have a look on how the animal is moving. And if it's like in a straight line, then it's more likely to be a wolf. I'd like to end with this picture. It's sometimes not easy to figure out how many individuals there are. As in this picture, I'll probably zoom a little bit in on this one, because you can see definitely one. If you look a bit more over there, we have one on the right side. Then we have a bunch together, which kind of splits up here, and this is probably two. So that's one, two, three, number four, line four, five, and six probably. So you just need to, it's basically try to figure out where is the best position to count them. If you want to know more about wildlife and wolves and stuff, check out the description. Last winter in Slovakia, we did some camera trapping and we got some wolves on the camera, so check out that video as well. Make sure to leave a like, that will make me so happy. And if you like more videos like this, consider subscribing. And if you have any questions, just put your questions in the comments and I'll try and answer. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.